Hi, welcome to That Thing That Happens. This is a new idea I have where just some things I like to talk about in music don't really fit in a category, so I'm just going to call them That Thing That Happens. If it happens more than once, it's a thing. This one I have like five or six examples of, and I know there's more, I just can't think of them right now. I don't really have a good name for them. I've never heard anyone exactly have a good name for these. Maybe someone does. If someone does, I'm sorry that I didn't read your account of these. I call them, I just made this up, two-beat metric joints. It's impossible to explain without just jumping in. Let's jump in. This is probably one of the first songs I ever noticed one of these on. This is the song Strangers by the Kinks. So when he starts singing, I'm gonna make some dots. Strangers. Okay. So I'm feeling 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. And really I feel like these, we could draw dots like this. And in fact, this and this seem even stronger than this. This is a full dot diagram of what I think the meter is doing in this song. Let's go back to where he starts singing and I'll Mickey Mouse along with it. 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. So I feel like the kind of breaks here and here. Strong, medium, strong, strong, medium. How would we notate this? I'll tell you what, it has baffled people. Some people would call this 4-4, and then a bar of 2-4, and then a bar of 4-4 again. Some people would call this bar 6-4, and this bar 4-4. Some people would just simplify more and call it a bunch of bars of 2-4. Oops. I don't really have to rewrite it. Which one is right? Some people would even maybe call the whole thing one really long bar of, how much does it add up to? 4, 8, 10. One bar of 10-4. Which one do I think is right? You didn't ask that, but I'm asking myself that. And geez, I don't know. I really don't know. I guess maybe this one is the most right, but I think it would be really ugly to look at, and I might write it this way. I don't think it super much matters exactly what meter you write it in, and that's not what I want to talk about. I don't want to talk about how you notate this, except I just did. I want to just talk about what it is and how it feels like. So I called this a two-beat metric joint. It happens in a lot of different songs, and I feel like it's usually like this like point of articulation. I have this feeling that it's like a like an elbow, right? Or a knee. It's like I don't know if this makes any sense, but like when he says, "Where you go into, I don't mind." And then it like goes somewhere else. I've built my whatever and I've like there's this feeling like there's this kind of trajectory of the phrase and this kind of trajectory, and that two beats is like this twist. There's this twisting feeling, and I think what I'm describing here is kind of the experience of what I would call the hypermetrical disruption that this causes, right? If we're in 4-4, we're always expecting a certain pattern of strong, weak, medium, weak beats, and it throws in this like strong, weak that doesn't fit in the pattern. But then it is subsumed in a larger pattern. This pattern I would most simply describe as 4 + 2 + 4. That's the repeating amount of beats. If we listen in again. 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. Again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. A lot of times it harmonically works, where there's like harmony X, chord X, and chord Y. And then there's this like mini chord Z that gets us from chord X to chord Y. It doesn't always work like that. Some of the examples I have don't have a chord there, but very often there is. And in this whole song, every time this happens, there's some in-between chord that gets us from chord X to chord Y. And these chords change. Okay, right when I started talking about it, it comes back into regular four for a little. But here it comes back. Chord X. Did you hear that? How it's in-between chord. Okay. It doesn't always act rhythmically like this. Here's another example.
One, two, three,
So, Outkast, Hey Ya, if you were alive and when did this come out? Like the early 2000s? And yeah, you've heard this song. Let's count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22. That's not divisible by 4. 4, 4, 4, 2, 4. 4. This is the repeating pattern in Hey Ya. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. See how that works? And listen harmonically again. Chord, 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 chord. Right, so this one actually has like an X and a Y. And there's our little Z harmony. And then, oh crap, we ran out of letters. Let's call it A. See how that works? If you want to know, it's a G chord, a C chord, this one is a D chord, and this one is an E chord. G, C, here comes a little elbow, D to E. Pretty neat, right? It's this oddball bar of two, throws off the hypermeter, and just, it feels really cool. It has this kind of launching pad kind of feel. That's what I'm trying to get at. Here, it's like it launches into the next four bars. It has this feeling like, do you ever, okay, weird metaphor, but I remember trying to do like the long jump in gym class or in track and field, and like you try and get your steps so that as you sprint up to the jumping line, you don't want to step over it. And always for me, when you get up close, you start to stutter step a little. And like, that's how I feel like this oddball bar of two kind of thing feels. It feels like you're getting ready to leap. So like you're going along smoothly and then you're like, and boom, and then you go again. Or kind of like if you've ever, if you care about your mother and you didn't want to break your mother's back, then you would endeavor to not step on a crack, because step on a crack, break your mama's back. And I don't want to break my mom's back, so sometimes I'll try to not step on a crack. And same thing, I'll be walking normal in my pace, and then I get up to the crack, and like I take some weird step in order to make sure my next step steps over the crack so that I don't break my mother's back, because I love my mom. I told you it was a weird metaphor. Sometimes the harmony doesn't change. Like, a good example, let's listen to the pattern in Storms by Fleetwood Mac. One, two, three, four. One, two, one, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four.
Dances slowly.
4, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. So I still feel like it's that don't step on the crack, don't break your mama's back feeling, or that like elbow or knee point of articulation feeling. There's still a hypermetrical disruption. But if we look at the harmony here, let's see, we got a G chord, I think. No, a D chord. Still a D chord. Then it's a G chord. G to A to B minor for the last two bars. So, slightly different pattern. And now it goes back to normal. Though it's still hypermetrically weird. Oh, never mind. There's so much I could say about this particular song. And I probably will one day. It does a thing, not to give it away for when I do this video, but it studiously avoids resolving on the tonic until the very end of the lyrics of the song, and it very much illustrates the song by doing so. Spoiler alert for later when I do it. There's another song that pops to mind from the 90s. Some little Tori Amos song called God. Let's wait till she starts singing the lyrics. That's when it happens. It's gonna go 4 plus 2 3 4 1 2 1 2 3 4 1 2 3 4. This one is like this. Can you feel that? Don't step on the crack. Get ready. Sometimes it feels almost like, I don't know, like you're getting extra ready for those next two bars. It's really neat. It disrupts the hypermeter, but it's not like it's confusing. And since every one of these falls into a regular pattern, right? It's a regular repeating pattern for all of these. I don't think it like gives you anxiety or anything. It doesn't like mess with your head. It's just kind of neat. There's a couple other songs I can think of that do this, where I will shamelessly plug St. Louisans, or former St. Louisans, like Cassie Morgan. Cassie Morgan and the Lonely Pine. Cassie Morgan has this song called No More Tears. And it does this thing. Once she starts singing, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. 4, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. Oop, extra 4 that second time. 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2. So this is kind of a longer pattern. 2, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2. And if you don't know this artist, this is Cassie Morgan and the Lonely Pine. Super talented singer and songwriter who I have had the pleasure of playing in a band. 2, 3, 4, 1, 2. Oh, dang it, she changed it right when I was going to talk about it again. And then last one, there is a defunct now band called Theodore. And this time it's a band I was actually in. But they had this song. It was actually the last song we recorded. I was only in it for like a few months. Theodore. And they had this song, Dead Heart. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. And if you're into the sound of this song, Theodore's got some other great albums, and I'm running out of time here, but that's it. That's the thing I'm called two-bar metric joints. Feel it.